लेट स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 50। फॉलोइंग इज द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ मयूर लिमिटेड। करेंट ईयर एंड प्रीवियस ईयर बोथ बैलेंसेज आर गिवन। शेयर कैपिटल विल गो इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, ट्रेड पेबल्स ऑपरेटिंग, शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोविजन विल गो इन ऑपरेटिंग। ओके, देन टेंजिबल एसेट्स, इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, intangible assets, what, let's see what is intangible assets. Intangible assets are given, what given, goodwill is given here, yes. So invest 115 to 19 means decreasing, it means it will go in operating activity. Current investment and cash equivalent both are same. Inventories in operating activity, trade receivable in operating activity. शेयर कैपिटल फाइनेंसिंग, प्रिफरेंस फाइनेंसिंग, SPR फाइनेंसिंग, जनरल रिजर्व ऑपरेटिंग, सरप्लस ऑपरेटिंग, है ना, एंड प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स इज गिवन ऑपरेटिंग, देन सम एडिशनल इंफॉर्मेशन आर ऑल्सो गिवन। प्रपोज डिविडेंड फॉर द ईयर्स 21 एंड 2020 आर गिवन। So we will take previous year proposed dividend. A machine costing 50,000, depreciation 30 was sold for 10. It means we need to prepare machinery account. Depreciation charged during the year 20,000. This is your current year depreciation. Interim dividend paid 20,000. It will be recorded in operating activity as well as financing activity. Income tax 35,000 paid. It means we need to prepare provision for tax account. So in this question, two accounts we need to prepare. One is provision and second is machine account. So let me start. First, I will prepare provision for tax account. Question number 50. Working note number 1. Provision for tax account. Provision for tax account. Okay. So provision for tax account starts from credit side. What do we write? We write opening balance. So by balance brought down. Let's see how much opening balance is given. Provision for tax opening balance is given 40,000 and closing is 50,000. So 40,000 opening balance is given. Closing balance 50,000, to balance carried down 50,000, and in adjustment there is one more point which is given. Income tax paid 35,000, hai na? So income tax paid 35,000 we write in debit side to bank account 35,000. This is our tax paid. And now balance will remain in credit side 50 plus 35,000 minus 40, so 45,000 balance is remaining in credit side. If balance remains in credit side, what does it mean? By statement of profit and loss. Children, this is our current year provision for tax or tax made, you can say. This is our current year provision for tax, which is appropriation, which will be recorded under operating activity. One more account we need to prepare in this question, working note number 2. Machine account we need to prepare. Machine account starts from debit side. So what do we write first? First we write opening balance. So we write here to balance brought down in debit side. Let's see what is the opening balance. The opening balance is given 2,80,000. So we write in debit side of machine 2,80,000. and closing balance will come in credit side by balance carried down. It is given 370,000. So 370,000. Now let us see what other informations are given. You can see point number 2 in adjustment. A machine costing 50, depreciation provided 30 was sold for 10. And point number 3, depreciation charged during the year was 20,000. So this is current year depreciation. So by depreciation, this is depreciation of current year, that is 20,000. Now you can see the cost of machine was 50,000. So cost of machine was 50,000. Depreciation provided there on 30,000. So this is accumulated debt. Accumulated debt was 30,000 on this machine. So after charging depreciation, the book value of that machine would be 20,000. Now this machine of rupees 20,000 is sold for 10,000. Machine of rupees 20,000 is sold for rupees 10,000. It means it is sold for the loss of rupees 10,000. Yes or no? So loss on sale of machine is 10,000 and machine is sold for rupees 10,000. So we will write by bank. This is sale of machine. Just a minute. By bank. This is sale of machine. 10,000. And by statement of profit and loss. This is profit and loss. This is loss on sale of machine, that is 10,000. Let's see where balance remains. Now let me do the total. $370,000 plus 40,000 is equal to 410,000. 410,000 is the total. Minus 280,000 is equal to 130,000. So if balance remains in debit side, what does it mean? If balance remains in debit side, it means it is purchase. We write bank account and this is purchase of machine. And where do we write purchase? We write purchase in investing activity. Definitely this sale will also be recorded in investing activity, right? So this sale will also be recorded in investing activity. Purchase will also be recorded in investing activity. So I hope this working note is clear. So statement. Cash flow statement. Okay. There are three activities. We start with first activity. First activity is cash flow from operating activities. Okay, so let's begin. From where do we start? We start with surplus. So let's see how much it is given. Surplus is given, earlier it was 30, now it is 48. So 18,000, hai na? Surplus difference of current year and previous year is 18,000, 48 minus 30. Current year minus previous year. 18,000. Then we need to write some appropriation. So add first, let's what we write, provision for tax of current year. Provision for tax of current year that we have computed, children. Current year provision for tax is 45,000. So 45,000 let's see if other provisions are given. Transfer to reserve is also given. Earlier it was 40,000, now it is 70. So 30,000 transfer to reserve. Transfer to reserve 30,000, है ना? Let's see if dividends are given or not in adjustment. So let's come in adjustment. Proposed dividend of previous year is given 50,000, है ना? Proposed dividend. Of previous year, which is paid during year, it is given 50,000. So we write 50,000. Let us see, interim dividend is given or not. Yes, interim dividend is given. Proposed dividend we have taken. Interim dividend paid 20,000. So interim dividend paid is 20,000. है ना? So all points are over, I think. Yes, all points are over here. So let's do the total. Let me do the total. 18,000 plus 45 plus 30, 75,000 plus 50 plus 20, 70,000. 1,63,000. What is this 1,63,000? This is our net profit before tax. Extraordinary items are not given, है ना? Then what do we add and in all these points? We add non-cash expenses. Non-cash expenses. So under non-cash expenses, let us see depreciation is given or not. Yes, children, depreciation is given. Charged during the year 20,000. It is given in adjustment. So depreciation of current year is given 20,000. Then intangible assets are given or not. So yes, dear children, intangible asset is given, goodwill. So earlier it was 115, now it is 90. So it is decreased by 25,000. So goodwill written off 25,000. Goodwill return of 25,000, or you can also write amortization of goodwill, you know? Now let's add. What do we add? Non-operating expenses. Let's see non-operating expenses are given or not. Yes, children, we have seen that loss on sale of machine is given. Loss on sale of machine. How much we have computed, I think. Loss on sale of machine we have computed 10,000. Hai na? And let's see if there is any interest on debenture or loan. It is not given. So nothing is there. Only one thing is there. Okay, and non-operating income is also given in adjustment. But in adjustment there is no non-operating income. Hai na? So let's do the total. 1,63,000 plus 45 or 10,55,000 is equal to 2,18,000. This 2,18,000 will be considered as operating profit before working capital changes. Now you can see in this operating profit we need to do some adjustment with it. For what? Adjustment for working capital changes, है ना? For current assets and current liabilities. So let us check current liabilities first. So in current liabilities, trade payables are given. Earlier it was 88, now it is 122. So increase in trade payables. Increase in trade payables. TP means trade payables, I am writing in short. 122 minus 88, 1,22,000 minus 88, 34,000. Increase in trade payable result in inflow of cash, so added. Then short term provision is provision for tax, we have already done. Then in current assets, current investment is the part of cash and cash equivalent, so we will not take it. Inventories, earlier it was 1 lakh, now it is 1,82,000. So increase in inventories by 82,000. Increase in inventories by 82,000 and increase in inventories result in outflow of cash. So we put bracket. Okay. Then trade receivable. There is no change in trade receivable, so we will not write it. Hai na? All points are over. Let's do the total. So 2,18,000 plus 34,000 and minus 82,000 is equal to 1,70,000. ठीक है, एंड देन व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू सब्ट्रैक्ट टैक्स पेड. तो हाउ मच टैक्स इज पेड डियर चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड ना प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स, 35,000 टैक्स इज पेड, है ना. सो लेट्स पे 35,000 टैक्स, टैक्स पेड 35,000, 1,70,000 minus 35 is equal to 1,35,000. It is in positive. So what do we write? Cash flow from operating activities. Cash flow from operating activities. Let's check it is correct or not. Cash flow from operating, yes, 1,35,000, it is flow. Now let us calculate investing activity. Second activity, cash flow from investing activity. Cash flow from investing activities. Anna? What do we write in investing activities? We write normally non-current assets plus non-current investment. Mainly these two major heads we need to consider here. Equity purchase of machine is 1,30,000. So it will result in outflow of cash. And sale of machine is rupees 10,000. This is inflow of cash. Total will be 1,20,000 negative, so it will be known as cash used in investing activity. Cash used in investing activity. Now the third activity is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. And what do we write in financing activity? We search normally the major head, shareholder funds plus non-current liability. So let's begin, hai na? Let's check. Equity share capital increased from 550 to 6 lakh. Let's see note number 1 what is given. Two types of shares capitals are given. So issue of equity share capital 4 to 5, 1 lakh. Issue of equity share capital 1 lakh result in inflow of cash. And preference share capital is redeemed by 50,000. So redemption of preference share capital by 50,000. Redemption of 10% preference share capital by 50,000 result in outflow of cash, isn't it? Let's see what else is given. Then this point is over. Then here security premium reserve is also given, 10,000. So security premium reserve, increased by 10,000, result in inflow of cash, then equity and preference, all these points are over. Then let's see, proposed dividend paid 50,000. Proposed dividend paid 50,000. Let's see what else is given. And then interim dividend was also paid 20,000. Interim dividend paid 20,000, है ना? सो रिजल्ट इन आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश. ओके, ऑल पॉइंट्स आर ओवर. सो लेट्स चेक कैश फ्लो, द टोटल ऑफ फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. सो 1 लाख, 1 लाख माइनस 50-50, 1 लाख, एंड माइनस 20 प्लस 10, माइनस 10,000. सो कैश यूज्ड इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी 10,000. कैश यूज्ड इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटीज 10,000, है ना? ओके, सो लेट अस डू द टोटल ऑफ ऑल दीज थ्री एक्टिविटीज. 10 माइनस 120, सो माइनस 130 एंड प्लस 135 मीन्स 5,000. सो नेट इंक्रीज इन कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट, व्हेन वी ऐड ऑल दीज थ्री एक्टिविटीज, वी गेट नेट इंक्रीज इन कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट्स 5,000. एंड देन वॉट वी डू, वी एड ओपनिंग कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट, ओपनिंग कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट हाउ मच इन द क्वेश्चन वी कैन सी 15 एंड 81. दिस इज ओपनिंग, बोथ आर एडेड टूगेदर. सो 15 प्लस 81, 15,000 प्लस 81,000, 8 प्लस 1 9, 5 प्लस 1 6, सो 96,000. एंड व्हेन वी ऐड 96,000 वी गेट 1,01,000. दैट मस्ट बी इक्वल टू द क्लोजिंग कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट, क्लोजिंग कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट. लेट्स चेक, सो 91 एंड 10,000, है ना? 91 एंड 10 इज इक्वल टू 1,01,000. 10,000 प्लस 91,000 इज इक्वल टू 1,01,000. चिल्ड्रन, आई होप द क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. From the following details relating to Grow More Limited, prepare cash flow statement. So, share capital is given, recorded in financing activity, reserve and surplus will go in operating, long term borrowing will go in financing, trade payable operating activity, short term provision will go in operating, है ना? Then non current assets will go in investing activity. Current assets here, inventories will go in operating, trade receivable operating, है ना? Share capital financing, general reserves operating, surplus operating, provision for tax operating, plant and machinery investing, land and building investing activity. Some additional informations are given. Depreciation at the rate of 25% was charged on the opening value of plant and machinery. It means we need to prepare plant and machinery account, I think. Yes. During the year, one old machinery costing 1 lakh, written down value 40, was sold for 70. So first we need to prepare plant and machinery account. 1 lakh was paid as income tax, and opening and closing provision for tax is also given. It means we need to prepare provision for tax also. Proposed dividend for the year ended 21 was 4 lakh and 20 was 2 lakh. So previous year proposed dividend is for our use. During the current year, the new debentures were issued on 1st October. So when we calculate interest on debenture, we pay this date in our mind. So this is our third working note. So three working notes which we are going to prepare here. So first I will prepare machine account, plant and machine account. Question number 51, working note number 1. Plant and machine account. Okay. Plant and machine account starts from the debit side. What do we write? Opening balance. In the debit side, we write to balance brought down. To balance brought down. Let's see how much balance is given. Opening balance 10 lakh. And closing balance will come in credit side by balance carried down. Closing balance is given 14 lakh. Then according to question, depreciation of 25% was charged on the opening value. So by depreciation, of 10 lakh is 2,50,000. One information is given, extra additional information. During the year, one machine costing 1 lakh. Costing 1 lakh, I am preparing here. Written down value 40,000. Okay, written down value is directly given. Okay. So, written down value is given 40,000. Sold for 70. Sold for 70. So what does it mean? It means sold for 30,000 rupees profit. So it is sold for 70,000. So by bank, and it is sold for profit of 30,000. So profit will come in debit side to statement of profit and loss. Yes or no, all points are over, hai na? So let's do the total where the balance will remain. So let me do the total. 14 lakh plus 2 lakh 50 plus 2 lakh 50 thousand plus 70 thousand, 17 lakh 20 thousand. Minus 10,30,000. 6,90,000 is remaining. If balance is remaining in debit side in plant and machinery account, what does it mean here? Bank account, and this is purchase of plant and machine. Okay, now one more account we need to prepare here, that is provision for tax account. So let me prepare provision for tax account. Provision for tax account. Provision for tax account starts from credit side. What do we write? Opening balance by balance brought down. How much opening balance is given of provision for tax? 1,40,000. So I will write 1,40,000. Closing balance will come in debit side to balance carried down. It is given 2 lakh And in adjustment, it is mentioned that 1 lakh was paid as income tax during the year. So to bank, rupees 1 lakh is paid as income tax. So 2 lakh plus 1 lakh is equal to 3 lakh. And 3 lakh minus 1,40,000 is equal to 1,60,000. This balancing figure here is known as by statement of profit and loss. And what is it? This is current year provision for tax. Okay. And there is one more working note which we need to prepare in this question, that is interest on debenture. Working note for interest on debentures. So here it is mentioned about interest on debenture that new debentures were issued on 1st October 2020. So let's see how much debentures were issued. 4 lakh debentures of 4 lakh rupees were issued, and earlier it was not there. So we need to calculate 10% for 6 months. So on 4 lakh, rate of interest is 10% for 6 months. 4 lakh ka 10%, 40,000 and half. It means it is 20,000. Yes or no? So interest on debenture is 20,000. Now we can start cash flow from operating activities. Yes, cash flow statement. We start with first activity, that is cash flow from operating activities. From where do we start? We start with surplus. Let's see how much it is given. So surplus is given in the question. Earlier it was 120, now it is 2,80,000. Then we need to add some appropriations. Here it is given general reserve. So transfer to general reserve is 1 lakh. It is an appropriation. Transfer to general reserve 1 lakh, and then we need to add provision for tax of current year. For how much we have computed provision for tax of current year? 1,60,000. Let's see if there is any dividend given in adjustment or not. So here it is mentioned proposed dividend 2 lakh of the previous year, hai na? Proposed dividend of previous year which is paid in current year, how much? 2 lakh rupees. So there is no other adjustment, hana? Everything is over. So let's do the total. So it will be 2 plus 1, 3, 4,60,000 plus 80,000 is equal to 5,40,000. 2, 3, 4, 60 is 5,40,000. This will be your net profit before tax. And then what we do? We add non-cash expense under it. Non-cash expense. Isn't it? Like depreciation of current year. Depreciation of current year, how much it is given? 25% ऑन 1 lakh वी हैव कंप्यूटेड 2,50,000 है ना. सो 2,50,000 सॉरी ऑफ 10 lakh है ना. डेप्रिसिएशन इज 25% ऑफ दिस 10 lakh दैट इज 2,50,000. Then let's see, is there any intangible assets which are given? Any intangible assets? Intangible assets are not given. No other thing is given in adjustment. Then what do we add? We add non-operating expenses. Non-operating expenses. Under non-operating expenses, what we write? We write is a profit on sale है ना. We write interest on debenture है ना. Interest on debenture, non-operating expenses. How much we have computed? We have computed 20,000 interest on debenture. All points are over then here. No anything is left. Then again we need to subtract non-operating income less non-operating income, and there is one non-operating income hai na, which we have written in account. What is that? Gain on sale of machine. Just a minute. We have computed the gain on sale of machine. Yes, 30,000 rupees gain on sale of machine. Gain on sale of machine. That is 30,000 that will be subtracted, and when we subtract what we get? 5,40,000 plus 2,50,000 plus 20,000 minus 30,000 is equal to 7,80,000. This 7,80,000 is your operating profit before working capital changes. Okay, and then what we need to do? We need to add some adjustment for working capital changes. Adjustment for working capital changes. Let's see just current assets and current liabilities. So start with current liabilities. Decrease in trade payable 2,40,000. Decrease in trade payable 2,40,000 result in outflow of cash. Then short term provision is not there. Inventories, current assets, increase in inventories 4 lakh. Increase in inventories 4 lakh will result in outflow of cash. Trade receivable, decrease in trade receivable 4 lakh. Decrease in trade receivable 4 lakh result in inflow of cash, isn't it? All points are over. So let's do the total. 7,80,000 minus 2,40,000 is equal to 5,40,000. Then we need at last pay tax. Tax paid, and how much was tax paid? Let me check. It is given in adjustment. Tax paid was rupees 1 lakh. Tax paid is rupees 1 lakh. Just a minute. 1 lakh. So 5,40,000 minus 1 lakh is equal to 4,40,000 positive. So this is your cash flow from operating activities है ना. 4,40,000 so from investing activity. Second activity, cash flow from investing activity. What do we write in investing activity, dear children? We write non-current assets and non-current investment. So let's check. We have already prepared one account, hai na? Let's see. We have prepared machinery account, and here machinery of rupees 70,000 has been sold for rupees 70,000. So sale of plant and machine for 70,000. Sale of plant and machine. Sale of plant and machine for 70,000 result in inflow of cash. And then in the same account you can see purchase of plant and machine by rupees 6,90,000. So purchase of plant and machine. Purchase of plant and machine 6,90,000 result in outflow of cash. When we purchase, it is outflow. Let's see what else is given. And you can see here non-current investment is also given, 2 lakh rupees. Earlier it was nothing, now it is 2 lakh. It means it is purchase of non-current investment. So purchase of non-current investment. Purchase of non-current investment by rupees 2 lakh. Result in outflow of cash. See, land and building, earlier land was 8 lakh rupees. Now land is 12 lakh. It means this is purchase of land by rupees 4 lakh. So purchase of land and building. Purchase of land and building by rupees 4 lakh. Let me do the total. So 4 lakh plus 6 to 8,90,000 minus 70,000 is equal to 12,20,000 negative. So it means it is cash used in investing activity. Cash used in investing activity. Okay, dear children. So third activity is cash flow from financing. So let's prepare cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. What do we write in financing activity, children? Shareholder fund plus non-current liability. These two things majorly we consider for financing activity. So let's begin. Share capital, earlier it was 16 lakh, now it is 20 lakh. So issue of equity share capital by rupees 4 lakh. Issue of equity share capital. Issue of equity share capital by rupees 4 lakh result in inflow of cash. Then nothing is given here. Let's see what is given in adjustment. Depreciation during the year 1 lakh. Proposed dividend. So proposed dividend of 21 is 4 lakh and 20 was 2 lakh. So previous year proposed dividend was paid in current year. So proposed dividend paid is 2 lakh. Proposed dividend paid rupees 2 lakh result in outflow of cash. And let's see what else is given in. We need to write non-current liabilities also. This 10% debenture will also come, isn't it? So earlier it was nothing, now it is 4 lakh. So in issue of 10% debentures. Issue of 10% debentures by rupees 4 lakh result in inflow of cash. And 10% debentures, we have already computed its interest, isn't it? interest on debenture 20,000. So interest on debenture paid, interest on debenture paid rupees 20,000, result in outflow of cash, you know. Let's see anything else is given. So all the points are over. So let me do the total. 4 + 4 = 8 lakh minus 2 lakh 20,000, 5 lakh 80,000 positive. So this is known as cash flow from financing activity. Okay, dear children, let's do the total of all these three activities, hai na? So 4 lakh 40,000, 4 lakh 40,000 minus 12 lakh 20,000 and plus 5 lakh 80,000. So result in negative 2 lakh. So this is known as net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. Net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. Now what we add here? We add opening cash and cash equivalent. Opening cash and cash equivalent. Let's see how much it is given. Opening cash is given 2 lakh. So when we add 2 lakh, what we get? Nil. So closing cash and cash equivalent is nil. Closing cash and cash equivalent is nil, and we can check here. Yes, it is nil. Hello? So I hope, dear students, the question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children.